though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. Well, I selected this passage, could have selected others, basically because of an experience I had last week. I was with my second oldest daughter, her husband, and my two grandsons over Labor Day weekend in Austin, Texas. And that is really, if you have troubles, you just go see the grandchildren, they all seem to disappear. Just great. But the oldest of the two is now 2 years and 2 months old, the smartest one, and keeps his mother out in this country. But he is really, right now, as Jacob of all the boys said, he's really into dinosaurs. Loves dinosaurs. What is kind of remarkable is that he'll sit there and look at the dinosaur book, and he'll, you know, point to the Stegosaurus, Triceratops, Brachiosaurus. Goes through all of these and he knows the names more than even my wife and I do. So he's really, really into it. And it was with great excitement then that they discovered that just outside of Austin is a little private business called the Dinosaur Park. And this business has got some pretty life-size, and I don't know how big dinosaurs really were in your life, but some pretty life-size figures of dinosaurs out on the piece of property, and you wander down this gravel path, and then there they are, the figure standing, made out of some neoprene, you know, substance that is weather resistant and very, very accurate to what we think a dinosaur would look like. And you wander down this gravel path. Well, this was probably the third or fourth time that little William had gone to see this dinosaur. The first time, his dad had taken him. And my son-in-law was telling me I made a big mistake the first time I wandered through with William. He said, we went through, one spot to stop and the dinosaur there and another one. And toward the end of the trail, and the trail was at least a half mile, toward the end of the trail, this was displayed all the dinosaurs. And my son-in-law said, I pretended to be afraid of the Tyrannosaurus Rex. When we came around the curve, I went, oh! And now little William has an ingrained fear of this dinosaur. Just from that experience, it's crazy, but it's so true. So I was, like I said, Adam and I took little William there, and this was probably the third or fourth time, and he not walk through that path anymore, that valley. He wants to be carried through. And we've gone out of our way. We'll go up and give the Tyrannosaurus Rex a hug to pet him to make sure that we have said, oh, he's really friendly, but no, he's just not sure. Because that first impression of fear that was connected to this dinosaur is still the same with the little guy, even to this minute. Isn't that a funny thing about fear? It can get a hold of you and it's very difficult to shake. And when I was thinking about that experience, I was thinking also then about my own fears, and then I began to think about your fears, and I went to the Bible to find a passage on fear that we can talk about today. So that's how we got to this passage, the long-winded explanation. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear saying, even though I walk through the valley, I will not be afraid. I will fear no evil. Years ago, I heard Dr. Oswald Huffman, many of you know who that is, but I heard this great preacher talk about this passage, and he said, Martin Luther translated the valley of the shadow as the dark valley. Now, I'm getting ready to go to Germany on Friday, right on Sunday. My wife and I are planning some plans for a trip over there this week. And so I'm working on my German. And I am very far from a German scholar. But I looked this passage up in my German Bible on Bible Gateway. They have Luther's Bible on Bible Gateway. And he does, in fact, use these words, in Finstern Tal, in Finstern Tal. Finstern is dark, and tall is the word for valley. So it would seem to me that Dr. Huffman was correct. But instead of saying the valley of the shadow of death, Luther interprets this, even though I walk through a dark valley. There's a lot of dark valleys that we walk through. And sometimes, you're in one, perhaps even in one right now. A valley that is in front of you and you can't shake whatever this valley is. I'm going to let you spend a few minutes to search your own mind and soul here to think, what valley am I facing today? We have, for example, some faculty members on our campus who are in the valley or have just come through the valley of a parent who is ailing. And that is a really difficult valley to walk through. What do you do? There's a lot of people who talk to them better than ours. University Pastor was on his way to be with his father again, who was in the valley of ALS. Wow, that's something. Now, I like that a lot better than the valley of the shadow of death, in the dark valley. How difficult it is when we get into those dark valleys. We have many people in my congregation who over the years have been without employment. That's a valley, a dark valley to walk through. There's a lot of fear associated with that kind of thing. Perhaps your parents, when your parents have gone through that experience. There's a valley of loneliness. That you're betrayed by a good friend. That's happened to me. I'm sure it's happened to you. Those are dark times. Even though I walk through the dark valley. Well, as long as I was getting into the German, I looked at the phrase before that. Even though I walk through, and I looked at how Luther translated that, he said, Und ob ich schon wanderte. Again, I'm not a big German scholar, but I know schon means already. And I'm sure the wanderte is sort of a past tense. So I would look at that and say, Luther say, if I have already wandered into the dark valley, I will fear no evil. And most of the time, that's when we really turn to our faith in the scriptures. Things are going great. We don't look at it that well. But if I have already wandered into it, then I will fear no evil. Now Luther again translates the word that we use as evil, unglück. And if it's in just common parlance, that just means unlucky. Or misfortune. Or an accident. Not quite sure if we could get into the mind of Luther why he chose that word, instead of the word that we use, evil. But I will fear no mishap, we might say, in my future. Well, I like to dig around in a little passage like that and find different angles to it. I find that different languages can help you really get into more of an expanded view. And it's fun. At least I hope you think it's fun. And it's a great way to discern what God may be saying to me today in that particular passage. If I have already wandered into this dark valley, that happening to you, I will fear no misfortune. So we are here today with a little bit of Heavenly Father, your word is so wonderful because it is so complex as well as so simple. We thank you that as we plunge into its depths and probe it, we find aspects and perspectives there that we might not otherwise have seen. And as we change, though the word does not change, it means different things to us for different times. Thank you for this very precious, effective word that is sharper than any two-edged sword and reaches out and touches where we need it the most. Help us by your Holy Spirit to explore that word, to take it into our spirits that it might touch us for times when we are in uncertainty and fear. Heavenly Father, we pray for all those who might be in that dark valley today. We certainly continue to pray for the Wetterling family here in Minnesota and for the valley that they have walked for so many decades and continue to walk. Please let them know how many stand with them and that we stand with them in spirit and in prayer. For all who have suffered great losses, we pray, touch them, because these hurts, these dark valleys, are certainly very dark. Touch us, each one of us here, where we need you. We right now, at this moment, open our hearts and our minds. We tell you what we're most worried about, what we're most fearful of. I'm going to ask for a moment now where we are in quiet and we simply open up our hearts. Tell our God personally what we would like him to know. Even though we walk through the dark valley, O Lord, help us to fear no evil.